Howdy, everybody. So on this video, I'm doing a third installment to my auto hotkey manipulating Chrome. Auto hotkey is really made for Internet Explorer, so a lot of people are always looking for how to move over to Chrome or Firefox. So I've been trying to find ways to get clever with that. I did two previous videos on using an extension that can pretty much allow you to do anything with auto hotkey. In this one, though, I'm going to just show you some simple how to open and close tabs in case you need to launch a bunch at one time and you want to use auto hotkey with that. Obviously, there's a lot of other stuff out there. There's extensions that do it, other programs. But if you want to stick with auto hotkey, you definitely can. So let's jump into the script here. So the first thing I want to do, I'm just going to set title match mode to 2. This is helpful just because down here where I have like if window exists Google, I don't want to have to type out like the full thing where it's like www.google.com. I just wanted to say, you know, something a lot more simpler. That way it looks cleaner, I think. It's easier. So the first thing I want to do is when I press the hotkey F1, I want to open two websites. You can open as many as you want, obviously. So the first one, I'm just going to have a Microsoft.com website open, and then I want my YouTube channel to open right here. So all that is run, comma, chrome.exe, and then the URL. If you're not using Chrome and you want to use Firefox or any other type of browser, all you got to do is just change this to the correct title for your exe. Make sure you put a return, because that's all I want to do. I don't want to do all this stuff down here just yet. Save that for later. So let's go ahead and show you how this first part here is going to work. So I'm just going to go ahead and launch that. Now, at the moment, you might not be able to see it, but I do not have Chrome open at all. You can have Chrome closed or open. It doesn't matter. It's still going to function correctly. So I'm going to push F1. It's going to launch Chrome, and as you see, it just automatically opened the two tabs for me. So there's my YouTube channel. And there's a Microsoft page about how to create a SharePoint. Now, let's say I have a bunch of tabs open, and I want to specifically close this tab without having to actually open Chrome, go to this tab, click the X. I want AutoHotkeys to do it because I'm lazy. Why not? So you got to get a little tricky here. In Internet Explorer, you could use comms to do this, which was way better, but can't really do that in Chrome, so I'm kind of mimicking some of the hotkeys that are associated with Chrome. Control-W will close out a tab, and then Control-Tab will cycle through your tabs. So let me show you that code. So I just got it assigned to the hotkey F2. If when exist, Google. I'm doing this because there's no point in running all the code below it if I don't even have Chrome open. What's the point? So this is just making sure that I have Chrome open. Once again, if you're using Firefox, just change this to Firefox or whatever other browser you're using. So in my brackets, I want to make sure that Chrome is the active window. That way, in case I have it minimized, I can still do this. Loop 10. This you can manipulate to how many times you want to loop. What that's doing is it's going to loop through a maximum of 10 tabs. Looking for the window that I want closed. I really never have more than 10 tabs open, but I've seen some people at my job who have, you know, 50 plus tabs, which is insane. You might need to change that to a higher number, or a lower number if you only have one or two open. That's perfectly fine. It's still going to work very quickly, but if you can make it shorter, the better it's going to be. So what I want to do is I wanted to check what the current tab selected is in Chrome. So as always in all my videos, I am going to post all this code into the description below. You can manipulate it to how you want, copy and paste it over into your own script. So it's saving the name of the tab as this variable, current window title. It's then going to check, you know, does the current tab contain the word creating? And you can manipulate this to whatever. So as you see right here, this tab right here has the word creating. So that's the one I want to close. If you have multiple tabs that are going to be open with the word creating in it, you might have to expand it to say, you know, creating a SharePoint to get more specific. That way it doesn't accidentally close another tab with the word creating in it that you didn't mean for it to do. If it is on that current tab, like I have here, I'm on this current tab, it's going to open Chrome, get the title, say, oh, yep, that contains the word creating. Let's go ahead and close it then. And all that is a send control W, which is just a shortcut built into Chrome to close the current selected tab, and then return. Now, if I wanted both of these up here to close, I can just add another if statement to it. That's perfectly fine. Now, if I'm on another tab, like let's say I'm right here, I need it to get over here so then it can find it. So all I'm going to do is say, okay, current window does not contain creating. Let's check the next tab. And all that is a send control tab, which once again is a built-in function to Chrome. So I'm just mimicking, you know, keyboard shortcuts that I would normally push myself. So it's going to tab over to the next tab. So it's going to go boom. Nope, still doesn't contain the word creating. Let's go to the next tab. Oh, this one does contain creating. Let's go ahead and close that one out. And then I'm left with whatever else I had open. So let's go ahead and show you the whole thing in action here. So I'm going to push F1. It's going to open. Let's give it a second to load. And then I'm just going to add, I'm going to open a few more tabs. Just for the heck of it, we'll leave one blank, why not? And let's go to this website that's no longer really active, unfortunately. So let's say I'm starting on the YouTube thing. I'm going to push F2. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and minimize this. Let's say I'm working in another program. I know I need to close that. I'm going to go ahead and push F2. It's going to bring that up. Oop. There we go. And as you saw, it went ahead and closed out that one menu item for me, or tab. Sometimes it gets a little hiccupy on the first time you ever use it for some reason. I find this to be true with a lot of AutoHotkey functions where the first time you do something, it just doesn't work. But after that, it always works. So you just saw there the first time I did it, it accidentally closed out the current tab. But from now on, it's going to work. I don't know why AutoHotkey has this issue. If anybody knows or a way to possibly like fix that, please comment below. Let me know. I would like to know. I've been trying for like the last year to figure out why that happens. Even some stuff like simple as like send control V for paste. The first time I use it, it just doesn't work. But then it will work 100% for the rest of the time that script's running until I relaunch it. So please let me know. I definitely would like to know. So yeah, I'll go ahead and post this down below. If you guys have any questions on how to expand on this, please definitely feel free to comment. Definitely subscribe. It helps me a lot. And I think there's a little bell icon you can click. I am releasing 3 to 4 videos every week, slowly getting more advanced, more variety. I try to see what you guys are asking both here and on the Reddit page for AutoHotkey. And I definitely like to try to target my videos to stuff that people are currently looking to do with their script and maybe can't find the answers online. You know, sometimes you have a question, it's very vague, and you'll find 50 different answers online and you're not sure which one to use for yourself. Hopefully these videos can help you. All right, guys, sleep tight.